In this video tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to conduct basic statistical analysis using Microsoft Excel. Even if you don't have access to Minitab or SPSS or SAS, Excel is fairly powerful in terms of generating statistics fairly quickly. In this tutorial, we'll learn how to generate the descriptive stats, mean, median, mode, standard deviation, range, minimum and a maximum value. We'll also see how to compute the percentiles. We'll see how to compute the frequency tables and generate a histogram. So let's get started. So this is the sheet that we want to replicate in this particular tutorial. As you will see, I have data on 142 students and their marks. These need not necessarily be marks in your situation. This could be salary, this could be consumer spend or sales data or any data related to your particular job. The methods in this are applicable to all sorts of data as long as the data is continuous and numerical. Now we have to generate these four outputs. The first we will be generating the summary table using the descriptive stats, mean, median, mode, standard deviation, the measures of dispersion, range and minimum and maximum value. Then we will be describing the data by generating percentiles very, very quickly. And then we will generate a frequency table and of course represent the frequency table in terms of visual terms as a histogram. These are our four tasks: summary, statistics, percentiles, frequency table, and histogram. So let's get started. So in the first task, let's generate this table, summary of the data. I already have this data copied onto another sheet, which is my sample sheet. So this is the data that I have, and now I'm going to generate the summary table. So go to data menu on the Excel and you'll find some menu data analysis in Excel, and you quickly click on there and you'll find something called as descriptive statistics. Now for some of you, it is possible that this data analysis menu is actually not appearing. In that particular case, you have to go to file, go to more and click on options. You'll find something called as Excel add-ins. Go to Excel add-ins, press on go. So just check the analysis tool pack and analysis tool pack VB and press OK, and this menu will appear. There is no need for you to restart the Excel. This menu will start appearing on your toolbar. Now once you get the menu, just click here, just click on descriptive stats. Now you have to specify the input range of the data. So these numbers were appearing because I did before this an exercise. So now what you need to do is specify the input range. You will see that there is a provision of specifying labels. So in this particular case, you can choose the header, and there are 142 students with the top row being a header. So I've checked labels in the first row. Now you need to define where you want the output range to appear. Make sure this summary statistics box is actually checked in, because that's the numbers. Those are the numbers that we want to generate, summary statistics. Output range, you just specify where you want the output to appear. I want it to appear in column H in the first row itself, and I press OK, and you will see Excel has quickly generated the summary statistics. So it says that the average marks are 7.54, the median is 8, standard deviation, which is a measure of dispersion, is 2.11, sample variance is 4.47, the range, which is maximum minus minimum, is also a measure of dispersion. So maximum marks are 14, which a student has scored, minimum is 3, and there are 142 observations. So Excel has generated our first table. This is what I'm going to call as a summary table. Now we quickly need to generate percentiles. To generate percentiles, let's assume that we want 10th percentile, we want 25th percentile, which is the first quartile as well. We want 50th percentile, which is the median as well. The 75th percentile, which is quartile 3 as well. 90th percentile, and then possibly 99th percentile. 99%. Now once you have typed this value, just go to the adjacent value and go to function and look for a formula which is there in Excel called as percentile. It's right there. Just double click to activate the dialog box, It is asking where the array or the data is. Now remember, just see that there is no functionality to specify a label here. So just choose the data. Don't choose the header. Just choose the data all the way down. We want to summarize marks. So I have 142 students, the first row being an adder. Just make sure you put a dollar sign here so that there is opportunity to dollars. Let me just type the dollars here. You can. So we have the dollars in. Just make sure that these dollars are there. And then we have to specify which percentile. So just choose the adjacent value. So for 10th percentile, choose this. Okay. And then just process OK. And then you just need to drag. So these are our percentiles. So you see, this is what the median value is. This is the same as 8. So we know that we have computed this correctly. Percentiles have an interesting interpretation. So if 75th percentile is 9, it means 25% of the students out of 142 have scored more than or equal to 9 marks. Similarly, if 90th percentile is 10, it means that 10% of the students have scored more than 10 marks. So percentiles are a very neat and a nice way of describing the data. I can just drag this formula here. So this is my 10th percentile. This is my P25. This is my P50. This is also the median. This is P75. This is P75. This is P90 and P99. So now we have the percentile table as well. I'm going to write percentiles. So we have accomplished two tasks. One is that we have generated the summary statistics and we have also generated the percentiles. Now we will go on to compute our frequency in the next exercise. So in the next exercise, we want to compute this frequency table. Frequency table is a very useful description of the data because it allows you to describe in different buckets how are the students distributed. So for example, between marks 0 to 4, how many students are there? So we see in this particular table that from 0 to 4 there are 10 students, from 4 to 6 there are 33 students, from 6 to 8 there are 55 students, and the same can be visually be represented by the tool called histogram. It immediately gives you the idea as to how these students are distributed. Or if this data was to be on sales, you will get the idea as to by salesperson, you'll get the idea how salespersons are doing in terms of performance of sales in different buckets. So the first thing to computing frequency table is that you need to specify these buckets: 0 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12. So we are going to write this, and you must remember, because there are two numbers, there is something called as lower bin, and there is something called as upper bin. So the lower bin number is 0 here, 4 here, 6 here, 8 here, 10 here, and 12 here. And the upper bin is the larger number here, which is 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. And these, so for Excel only uses the upper bin data to compute, which is why in this frequency table you only see the upper bin data. But it actually means that between 0 to 4, how many students are there? So this is called as a class, and this gap 4 minus 0 is called as the class interval. Now we are going to compute the counts of students. So this upper bin needs to be specified. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this and copy it in my sample file somewhere here so that I have this data now. So this upper bin, I'm going to use it to construct the frequency table. So now what I need to do is go to data analysis. There's something called as histogram. So don't look for frequency under this menu. There is no specific menu called as frequency. Now what is available is a histogram, but this menu itself computes the frequency table for you. So press OK, and now it is asking for the input range. The input range remains this. Remember, again, this has the labels option, so you can choose the marks. So I'm choosing the labels option here, and now it is asking where is the bin range. Remember that, make sure there are dollar signs here so that you know. Now bin range, it only requires upper bin, and it is automatically assumed that what the lower bin is. So you only need to choose upper bin, and remember I have chosen from upper bin till 12. Now you might ask why I'm ignoring the other row. So you will see that Excel will automatically compute the remaining data if it's falling out of ranges and will put in the last bucket automatically. So choose the labels here as well. So make sure that the upper bin is chosen and you specify this as a header. Then in the output range, you need to specify where the output should be. Let me copy it here and let's press OK. So we also want histogram, so also choose the chart output. Okay, if you want a reverse histogram, you can choose Pareto. Currently, I'm just using a chart, simple histogram. So press OK. And you see that the histogram has been generated. And we also have got our frequency table, which I can now drag here. So this becomes my frequency table. And now you don't need this, so you can move this around here. You can arrange this histogram here. Now, one of the most important things that a lot of analysts actually don't do is that they actually don't format the sheet. But it's always a great idea to format the sheet so that it looks readable to people. It's just a way of showing respect to your clients, customer, whosoever is going to see the sheet that you neatly arrange this. So I'm going to format this very, very quickly. And you can also develop your own style in terms of formatting. So what I need to do is, let me first do the histogram formatting. So you go to chart design. Excel already offers some template. This is looking good. We should be fine with this. Now what I need to do is, other than histogram, let make these grid lines disappear because they are a distraction. It is looking better now. So now what we need to do is, let's embellish this a little bit, increase the font size of the tables, draw a little bit of border around it. You can drag this table all the way up, select everything and move it up. Excel is pretty efficient in that. So this is our percentiles tables, this is our frequency table. You can say that this is the frequency table. Frequency tables table, and you see that if you add this up, this will total up 242 students. So I'm summing it, and you see that these are 142 students, out of which there are 10 people in the 0 to 4 marks, and there are 33 people from 4 to 6. You might ask a question, if somebody is on the boundary, let's say somebody has scored 4, which bucket does he go into, right? Because buckets apparently overlap. So he goes in the first bucket. That's how it is computed. So if somebody has scored exactly 4 marks, it will be reported in the first bucket, not in the second bucket, and so on and so forth for the rest of the buckets. So this is how we get. You can quickly copy this format to this as well, and this as well. And one thing is that we can actually reduce the decimal and make the decimals equal, so that this looks better. Provided this thing a little bit of color, whichever color is your preference. Let's say this, and I think this sheet is now looking very similar to our output sheet, and we have accomplished all the tasks in this. So once more, just to summarize, this is one very quick way of summarizing the data. And the data need not be limited to just 100 of rows. You can have hundreds or thousands of records, as many as Excel can accommodate. These methods are fairly generic. You can generate very quickly summary table. It gives you all the summary description of the data, the minimum, the maximum, the measures of dispersion such as range and standard deviation, the average value and the median value. Comparing the median value and the mean value and the skewness, you will also get some sense of the direction of skew as well. And you can sense that from histogram as well. Percentiles are able to also describe the important. For example, you can say if you want to identify outliers, anybody who is over more than 90th percentile could be considered as an outlier. or if this is consumer spending, you can say that those are premium customers. All right, so with that, we conclude this tutorial. Thank you very much for watching.